ね、システムオブダウンの、ね、2人にちょっと来てもらってるんですけどね、ちょっとね、今回はやばいですよ。システムオブアダウンはね、すごいもう今一番注目されてるバンドの一つなんでね、新人にしてはすごいイケてるバンドです。じゃあちょっとね、自己紹介してもらいましょう。 Could you introduce yourself to the camera?
This is Serge.
This is Dan.
We are one half of System of a Down.
One over two.
Alright, okay. And since it's the first time since the System of a Down is being introduced in Garage Heads, could you just tell us how the band was formed and everything? Go for it.
Go for it, dude.
Well, me and him used to be in a band together, and that band split up, and this band formed.
That was simple.
In a nutshell.
What was the band called before?
Soil.
Soil. Did you have a record out?
No.
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 So it was like a local band in California.
Not even. It was like a local band in our
North
studio. Nobody heard us except for us.
So how did the other two came?
It just fit into place. We knew each other. Shava would always come to our rehearsals, and he'd always be there, and it just didn't work out with our old bass player, so Shava came in, and he really fit in like a piece of a puzzle, you know? And same with John, you know? We knew him through friends. He was in another band. We shared rehearsal studios with him, and we had another drummer. Like, it didn't work out, and we got John, and he fit in like a, you know, perfect piece of the puzzle. So now we're happy.
All right. After you made it big for the major record companies, did anything changed around you?
After we got signed, you mean?
Uh-huh.
Nothing really. Nothing major changed.
Not in our personalities or anything, but life did change, though, I have to admit. I mean, we're on tour. We're not as stable as we were before. We're constantly on the go, you know, and you know, it's a little different now. We're recognized on the street when we're walking and stuff like that. So things like that. But our personal lives, we've pretty much are as close to the same people as we were before all this happened. You know, like we try to stay grounded.
How was the Japanese crowd last night in Osaka?
Crazy. When we came to Japan, some friends told us that, you know, they're gonna be a little shy, so it's gonna take them a little while to get into it and stuff. And we're like, okay, that's cool, you know? And from the first song, kids were on stage, you know, stage diving and just going nuts, you know?
Yeah,
and we're like,
pretty
fuck, dude, what's going on here, you know?
This time around in Japan, it's like we're gonna leave in a couple days, and I really don't wanna leave. I like it here. I like it here a lot. I think people here are very hip. I think you guys are ahead of the U.S. in a lot of ways when it comes to style, when it comes to certain technology things. Like, I was in a cab the other day, and when the cab stopped, the doors opened by itself. You don't have that in you. I felt like I was, like, in the Jetsons or something, you know what I mean? Like,
did you see that?
I feel like you guys are a little ahead of us in some things.
Maybe in some ways.
Yeah.
Respect as well.
Exactly.
Respect for people, honor, cleanliness. That's very, very important in the community, you know? And it lacks, you know, in a lot of the West. And I think that's something that I really saw here that really caught my eye, that I like.
People are very gracious.
Yeah.
Very nice. We were too last night in front of the hotel. There was a few fans, and they took us out to a bar. That's the thing, where over here, people are just so nice. It feels like they're so happy to see you. They make you feel welcome. And that's the most important thing for people in our situation, like band members and stuff. Because we're always away from home. And to feel welcome and to feel like you're at home is real important to us. And we miss it a lot. So when we came here, everybody welcomed us, like, in a really, with open arms, you know? And that's one thing that I dig about this place. It's really cool.
Well, you should come over here more often.
We want to, definitely.
We will. We'll be back.
What do you have in mind? What do you always have in mind when you make like songs?
Try to, you know, do something unique. Try to do something that we haven't heard before. Something that's our own. Something that we can call our own, you know? And we try not to be afraid, you know, to try new ideas. You know, some people are afraid that their friend's gonna say, hey, that's stupid. We don't care what anybody said. If we like it, we like it. You know what I mean? And that's the way free form of art should be. You know, you should be free to express yourself. There is no such thing as a bad idea. It's a matter of opinion. You know, a bad idea to one person is a great idea to the other. You know what I mean? So we always try to just keep expanding, looking for new ways, new sounds, new influences.
Speaking of new sounds, it was the first time that I heard someone scream so much and sing in the same song. How do you manage to do that? How do you manage your throat?
Oh, I don't know. I just do it. I don't think about it.
Did you do that in Soil?
Soil? Somewhat, but Soil was more progressive, more heavy, more yelling, more just crazy, but somewhat, yeah. That was Soil. The things that we did in Soil were a precursor to System of a Down. It was like the first stage before System of a Down kind of thing.
Because I felt
it developed us to bring us to System of a Down, in a way.
Because your vocals is your style. It has your own style, so I was really amazed when I heard it.
Thank you.
I hear that your show is really aggressive and really...
No, it's really mellow, man.
Really?
It's like watching Simon and Garfunkel.
Come on. How is the show going to be tonight?
I hope wild. I hope the crowd gets into it as much as we like to get into it. It's not... When it comes down to a show, the crowd cannot just say, oh, okay, you guys have to put on a good show for us. Well, we expect you to come in there and kick ass just as much as we're going to get up there and kick ass so we can all have fun. It's like a group effort. People come... Yeah. We'll be right back.
anyone have marijuana? I know it's really illegal, but smoking it.
People come up to us and say, wow, you guys were great, you guys were great. And if the crowd was great, I'd say, man, you guys were fucking great. You know, it's like, you guys made it great, just as great as we did. You know, it's like, we share it. We're in this together for an hour, hour and a half, 40 minutes, whatever, however long you play. Us and the crowd, we're in it together. We're like a team. Let's do it. Let's try to have a good time tonight. You know what I mean? Let's try to achieve this. Let's bring it out of ourselves. You know, dig into yourself. Don't be afraid. Get up. If you want to get up on stage, get up on stage and sing. You want to jump off the stage, jump off the stage. You want to just sit there and watch. If that's your style, go ahead. Just don't be afraid to do what you want to do on stage or off stage. You know what I mean?
Don't hurt anybody and enjoy yourself.
Yeah, as long as no one gets hurt. Which, you know, it seems like everyone's got each other's back, especially during pits and stuff. I always see people raising each other up when someone falls on the floor. That's beautiful, you know, and it's just a good time. We want to have a good time. We want to give the audience something to remember after they leave and something they can hold on to, you know. And same with us. We want to have a good show so we can remember that audience and we can hold on to that audience.
Cool. You've been touring with Slayer. How's that?
Evil.
Amazing. They're an amazing group of guys. Their music has been an inspiration to us from day one. And, you know, the tours were just eye-opening. I mean, our first U.S. tour was with Slayer, and our first European tour was with Slayer. So we were like, they popped our cherry, you know what I'm saying?
So how was the Ozzfest?
Oh, that was fun.
It was like going to summer camp. You know when you go to camp and they send you away, except like you're at summer camp with a bunch of heavy metal bands. You know what I mean? It's like you're, you know when you go to school and you go to the cafeteria and you're gonna have lunch and you see all your friends in your class? Well, you know, it's lunchtime, you go into the cafeteria and, you know, it's like the guys in, you know, different band, like Cold Chamber and stuff. So it's like, it's different because it's funny, you know? It's fun.
Be a great lineup too.
Yeah, fun lineup. It's a lot of good bands this year on Ozzfest.
What is hardcore to you? Hardcore music.
Another name.
You know, it's a label for music, man. Everyone likes to label things, and you know, it's like some people might call what we do hardcore. Then there's parts in our music, personally, in our stuff, there is parts that aren't very hardcore. We like to mix, you know, the hardcore with the gothic, with a lot of things. Hardcore is an attitude to me. You know, to get up there and just be, you know what I mean? Like, just get up there and kick butt and be hardcore, you know? And it's a music with a lot of attitude, in my opinion. With a lot of aggression, with a lot of attitude.
Modified metal.
Alright. Our last question. Since it's 1999 and the new millennium is coming soon,
Thinking a lot of things about it. Well, the new millennium brings new ideas and new thoughts into people's minds, and it brings a lot of fear as well. A lot of people are afraid of what's coming ahead. I think instead of being fearful, I think you should open your eyes and see what's going on in the world and wake up, wake yourself up from inside and help everyone else wake up, because if things go in this direction, none of us are going to have kids long enough to be our age. So it's something to think about.
You know, the world ending and not ending is all up to us. You know, it's all on our hands. It's our decision. If we want the world to end, we can make it happen tomorrow. If we want to survive, then we got to get together and survive.
Get out of your life. Whatever's important to you isn't really important to the world. There's more important things. So start looking out for that. Because be a part of that as well. And because everything affects everything else. You think that your life may not be affecting too many people, but it does. Your silence affects people. Your silence is sometimes more deadly than your words, and you don't know it. You know what I'm saying? So you gotta just open yourself up and see what's going on. You can't be like this. You know how the horses have those things they put on them to walk that way? People are like that today. They're like those horses. And it's time. If it continues that way, it's gonna end very soon.
All right, then last but not least, message to the fans.
Keep on rocking, Japan.
Basically.
All right, thanks a lot. Thank you.
Take care. Thank you, man.
We will fight the heathen! We will fight the heathen! We will fight the heathens. We will fight the heathens. No, we will fight the heathens. We will fight the heathens. No, we will fight the heathens. We will fight the heathens.